welcome. Thank you so much for coming to our final concert of the year. Behind me is the Brockton High School Repertory Chorus, and we are excited to perform for you four pieces. Our first piece is the Liber Tango by Argentinian composer Astor Piazzolla. And the Liber Tango symbolizes a break from the classical tango into what's called the Tango Nuevo, which means the new tango. And Piazzolla was really the first person to invent that style of the tango. So the Liber Tango combines libertad, which means liberty, and the tango. So we hope you enjoy. So much. At this time, I'd like to recognize our collaborative pianist for the evening, Mr. Michael Kregler. And we also have joining us from Rhode Island, Mr. Greg Charest on percussion. Our next piece is an inspirational pop ballad by Christina Aguilera, and it's called The Voice Within. It'll feature a solo by Lara Mendez.
Tears will dry, you'll soon be free to fly. soon you're gonna see your brighter day.
Thank you. The traditional Appalachian folk hymn, "Will the Circle Be Unbroken," has undergone many changes over the years, and the arrangement you're about to hear has new lyrics, and it juxtaposes two styles. It's going to start off with a bluegrass trio, and it's going to go into more of a gospel style in the middle. It celebrates the power of song to create a community, which is what we're all about here at Brockton High School. The trio in the beginning, thank you, you can applaud for that, absolutely. The trio in the beginning will be sung by Marian Cunha, Laura Mendez, and Leah Parrott, and we hope that you enjoy.
Yeah.
Our final selection is Rosephony Powell's Still I Rise. She's really a favorite composer of mine, and we sang a piece of hers at the March concert, if you were there. This piece is inspired by Maya Angelou's poem of the same title, Still I Rise. And it'll feature a solo by Haley Deltano, a small group behind me, Delette Brumberger, Marion Cunha, Amaya DeLong DePina, Ariana Gomes, and Anya Leahy. And in the music for this piece, Rosephony Powell, the composer, writes the following. Quote, "It is a woman's anthem, saluting the strength of women to persevere through life's difficulties, low self-esteem, physical and emotional abuse, prejudice, abandonment, and such like. In summary, though a woman's life or past may be filled with tears and heartaches, with each day that she finds herself still living, she finds that she has grown stronger and risen a little higher because her circumstances have not overcome her. Thus, every new day can be one of hope and joy, because regardless of the past, today, still I rise."
Still I rise, yes, still I rise.
Jump like a bud and rose, my bloom is nourished by rain.
Still I rise.
Thank you. Next up on the program is the concert band under the direction of Mr. Kevin Cardell. Thank you very much. That was our opening piece entitled Heroic Fanfare. If you were here for our holiday concert, you'll notice that on the program, one of the pieces that was on the program we didn't perform. Thankfully, it's also a movie title, so we can pull it out and do it for this concert too. Less music I have to rehearse. So we are going to play some selections from Tim Burton's absolutely fantastic movie, one of my favorites. This is selections from The Nightmare Before Christmas.
Thank you. As you know that, and if you're right here, we have the pleasure of having probably one of the finest jazz player and professional player in this country. One of the things that we try to do is to expose our students. If you were here at the spring concert, you noticed that we had a great composer, and actually we commissioned a work in Brockton, the people that were here, and the kids got a chance to see, to play something that was written specifically for them. It would be standing here, standing in our library, and it was a great, great experience. I've had the pleasure of knowing Chris Padala for many, many years. We're friends. We talk a lot about, mainly about food. Every year that he's been here, it's been an absolute pleasure. And I said, I try to expose to the kids when they hear somebody, well, that's good. I says, well, let me let you listen to someone that sits in for Barbra Streisand or the National Symphony. Or if people that remember Chuck Mangione back in the 70s, who's still popular, all the recordings done by that is Chris performing. And you can see, by the way, that's half of his bio, if you read it, and it's out here. Ella Fitzgerald, Chick Corea, Ray Charles, Stevie Wonder, Natalie Cole, just to name a few that he's behind. And he's also behind some TV themes that he's performing and so on. So, Mr. Cardell said, you think there's a chance of Mr. Vidala performing the students? Sure. So I said, well, he didn't say sure. I just said, sure, there's not a problem. So when he showed up today, the other day, yesterday, I said, you're playing with the ninth grade group? And I said, you're playing this? Really? I said, okay. So we're going to have feature, and we'll tell him a little body, and we'll feature us with our band and listen to him. So we're going to have, please welcome Mr. Vidala, and he says he joined us to perform one piece. Chris Vidala.
I've been wanting to do that one for a long time. And I finally have the group of woodwinds that could pull it off. So good job to them too. So as I said before, if you were at some of our previous concerts, sometimes I put things on the list and we just never get to perform them because they're just not quite ready yet. This is another one. So this was from our spring concert. We were gonna do it, and again, just a little bit more time. So this is, you're gonna recognize a lot of songs in here, especially those of you that are kids at heart. This is a Fantasy on Childhood Songs.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. One more quick change, and we'll bring up Mr. Cunningham again with the, this time with the concert choir.
Crossan's arrangement of Fragile by Sting, and it featured solos by Angelina Damiani, Joy Pover, and Giovanni Perret. We are so incredibly fortunate to have Mike Kregler as our collaborative pianist, and not only is he a gifted accompanist, but he's a very gifted composer, and some of you might know that. If you were at our Pops concert last year, you heard his salsa piece, Sabor. And actually, the seniors behind me, the senior boys, have had the privilege of singing a piece by him all 4 years that they've been in this choir, which is really an incredible thing for a high schooler to be able to sing an original work by a composer who works with the choir. So we're so blessed. And this year, we're singing a very special piece of his. I'd like to introduce Mike to talk to you about his piece, Into Your World.
Being here and supporting this truly excellent music program. I've been here several times, as Matt already alluded to, and each time it gets more special. It's an extremely warm and sincere place, and I'm very thankful to come here and to accompany and to have compositions performed. My name is Mike Kregler, and I'd like to say a few words about the uniqueness of this next piece. My three-year-old son, Joe, was officially diagnosed with autism spectrum disorder last August. His lack of eye contact and his reluctance towards physical contact were some of the signs, so the diagnosis itself was really no surprise. But what I did feel that day was confusion. Why Joe? And more importantly, what now? The same day he was diagnosed, two very special friends of mine who work in the field of autism gave me hours of their time via telephone and Skype. With surprising enthusiasm and refreshing positivity, they offered such wise words as, "He's not broken," and "Get into his world." So I did. And since that day in August, my family and I have enjoyed a truly incredible journey, helping Joe to connect with us, and more importantly, getting to know him. His overall progress has been amazing. The amount of eye contact and the desire for physical contact have increased immensely. He smiles more every day. And despite his limited spoken vocabulary and his sometimes seemingly distant demeanor, I have been fascinated to discover how he is actually listening and what it is that he really sees. In the field of choral music, I am proud of how we stress inclusion and diversity, and how we celebrate and honor our differences. So it seemed only natural to write this choral piece about Joe. Independent of his autism, Joe is remarkably content and sweet. He loves to spin circular and shiny objects, and he often communicates his contentment through a sweet and expressive humming. This humming is intentionally built into the composition. Also built into the piece are some physical gestures that Joe tends to perform. Tilting his head and waving his hands and fingers before his eyes. In the spirit of inclusiveness, we invite you, the audience, to also perform these gestures when you see the choir doing them. Finally, I would like to offer my continuous thanks and to my dear friend and colleague, the incomparable Matt Cunningham, and this... also to this truly first-rate ensemble for their always open minds and hearts, for their dedication, and for the privilege of having, my privilege of having them perform my music. A feat they have done many times, and if I have anything to say about it, will continue to do so. Even though this piece did premiere, had received its premiere a short while ago at Providence College, it warms my heart truly that tonight it is receiving its Brockton premiere.
Thank you.
Thank you. Our next selection is an arrangement of the 1980s hit True Colors, and it was made famous by Cyndi Lauper, if you might remember. The song has become a standard in the LGBTQ community and also a beacon of hope for autism awareness. However, today it takes on another meaning. The senior class of 2018 will be singing this piece, True Colors, next Saturday at their graduation. And we do hope that they are never afraid to let their true colors show. And at this time, will the class of 2018 seniors please raise their hand and be recognized? Contributions to this program over 4 years. Haley Deltano will be our soloist, and we hope you enjoy Matthew Brown's really marvelous arrangement of True Colors.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. Before our final piece, one last thank you to Mr. Greg Charest, our percussionist. And of course, Mike, for lending their talents to the concert. This last piece has always resonated with me from the time I was a little one watching Lion King, and I'm sure you might remember that movie, hopefully. And I always talk about how life is a circle. It really is. That's why I'm back here teaching at Brockton High. I went to school here, I'm teaching here. Life is a circle. The circle never ends. Yes, it may be fragile, but trusting the voice within, we can still rise above anything life throws our way. Our true colors are beautiful like a rainbow, and if we take time to get into each other's worlds, perhaps we may see each other more clearly. It's the circle of life. It moves us all through despair and hope, through faith and love, till we find a place on the path unwinding in the circle of life.
Thank you.
as we continue on, just before we start the band, for the last several years, it has been a tradition for us to remember a great music educator that we lost a few years ago, and his scholarship has been established under his name, and speaking, of course, of Mr. Ferrante. I've been taught an assistant for many, many years in band one. I'm a freshman band, played in the jazz ensemble. And there's two members of our original quintet that Bob and I performed professionally. And so they established it, scholarship, and his wife, Tina, is here this evening representing. So just a brief introductions, and to remember a great music, a great friend, and a great musician.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. It's a pleasure to be here. I'm really honored to be able to present the scholarship this year. And I am a member of the committee that was really formed by his wife, Tina, who's out there in the audience. You might just want to wave there, give her a hand, because she wanted to do something to remember Bob, who passed away about 2.5 years ago. And he was a great colleague and friend and musician and a friend to us both. And the committee consists of myself, I'm Robert Nichols, this is Ted Haynes, and his wife Mary Haynes and Shibuzo Anin. And we get together in the spring to go over, students are required to write an essay explaining what experience in band has done for their life. And so, without further ado, I'd like to announce the winner of this year's scholarship, and it is Ryan Shaw.
Ryan has been accepted to Boston University. There's also Mr. Ferrante's university. So this is the Robert Ferrante Scholarship, Memorial Scholarship. We present this every year, and hopefully students next year will apply as well. So for myself, thank you so much for your time.
Thank you, Bob. Thank you. Second to kind of warm up the horns a little bit. a little jazz theme that we're going to do for you. And so we're going for the next three numbers. We're going to invite her back here, like I said, one of the finest players. And soprano sax is an instrument that a lot of people don't understand because you get Kenny G usually playing it most of the time. But this guy here plays a mean soprano sax, trust me. So let's welcome Chris Vidalis to join us. Happy that he gives his arrangements. He plays this as one that he did with a major college in the United States, so he's able to, for us to use it. So we're going to start off with a little bit of Duke Ellington, Take the A Train. Phil Woods, actually from North Shore. Springfield, one of the greatest jazz artists in the world, passed away. And so he studied at the Eastman School of Music. And so this was written by the great Quincy Jones, by the way, who has written so many great stuff to in dedication to his teacher. So he said, can we do this beautiful ballad? I hope I enjoy this arrangement of Quincy Jones.
Thank you. We have
We also want to, he's got one more to go with us. We also want to recognize our trio out there. I want to thank Mrs. Wheeler from East Junior High to come in and fill in on piano for us out there. And Veronica Mann on bass. The next number is very synonymous to what this is. Once again, if you remember Chuck Mangione, and I would say, you know, I had the students listen to it and absolutely love it. You get it? You never heard Chuck Mangione's band. It's just beautiful music, light jazz, rock. He plays in many, he also plays flute, clarinet, oboe, all the saxophones, and bass flute, alto, which is about this big. You'll hear in a tune called, what year was that? The bass flute there, the beauty. Yes, Bellavia, which is up there. It's got some Spanish signs on it. Look it up. Chuck Mangione, by the way, the great number that they did was a tune called Feels So Good. And it also featured in the 1989 Winter Olympics. They opened up there at the Placid, Lake Placid, Chuck Mangione's band, and I saw Chris actually for the first time. So it's a great group. It's a great group. And like I said, the kids listened to it and they kind of got into, well, this is great. So again, exposure to great stuff. That's what the kids will go for it. Anyway, so we continue on this this number he did with us with the jazz ensemble in 1993, which originally for jazz ensemble, the Children of St. Chaz, it's called, and he Chuck Mangione wrote this, but this particular piece was just written for him. So we were actually kind of commissioning this thing. It's the first time he's performed a concert band version of the Children of St. Chaz. I think you'll enjoy this. It actually starts off almost like a halftime show drum thing. So here's premiere? Okay, The Children of St. Chaz. Thank you. Kiss for now. Tune for this evening. Before we go on, I just want to thank all of you for supporting us for many years and your great compliments that you tell me all the time how much you enjoy this. I'll tell you this right now, there aren't too many schools putting this on right now in a system like this of artists, composers, and so on. Our kids are getting an incredible experience, and why anybody would ever think of sending their kids anybody else, I don't understand that at all. But anyway. Top class all the way, you people that came in last week, you enjoyed the musical, everybody came in, it's like a Broadway production. And this is not the norm. I just want everybody to know that this is not, Chris come out there, he goes all over the school and sees, you know, sees bands like this and better can play this stuff, and he says, it's unbelievable at what is going on. Matt has come in and join us, Circle of Life. He started with us in the chorus of the band, and he came back here, and if he doesn't behave, he's gonna go back out there again. No. Just getting around with him is great. He calls me the mentor every time there's something wrong. So, well, you taught me how to do it, you know. I'm not sure, but he's also a fine clarinet player too, because he also performed with the band. And to the parents, you talk to him, and I have to say this: you see Chris and so on, and practicing. You don't get to be at the stage by just not picking him. So if the kids are not doing that well, you know, give them a little push. Okay, give them a little push, especially to the freshman students, because an experience such as this is an experience for life. Trust me. And they all come back and tell us. Unfortunately, this is also the last tune that the seniors will perform on stage, kind of a sad ending, because I keep on telling them the last note of this concert for them. For the most part, unless they go into music, it'll be the end of their career. Since they're fourth grade, when they start squeaking and squawking, you'll complain about it, right? And you did. So I'd like the seniors to just stand up for the last time at this stage. See? Song. Thank you. But again, thank you for your support. It's been great because it's part of it. You know, playing in an audience like this, it's great for me. I also want to thank Mr. Cardell and the concert band before we go on. And he has a tough job. They come from all over the 4, 5, 6 junior highs we have. He's got to put them all together, many multi levels. But towards the end, they get here and then they move on. And this is what's expected for them to perform. So, if the instrument is under the bed, it's not working. Okay, despite what everybody thinks, okay? And, you know, he practices every day, so do I, and this guy, all our professional. So push it a little bit, it's better, okay? All right, so we want to close up with a tune called The Blues Machine. And it goes to a couple of different stylistic of blues, and I hope you enjoy this concert. And again, once again, thank you all for the great support. Thank you. Thank you. careful going on. Once again, please don't get close to unless you have to use the elevator. Go out that way. Do not block. Okay. Thank you. Have a nice summer, all. We have more.
That we wanted to give to Mr. Macrina on our last concert together. It's not much, but it's something that we all just wanted to give him. Roses and performance. We were all back there crying. You couldn't see us. But the blues, we're all feeling very blue right now, but it's meant to be a really happy time for us, so we wanted to thank Mr. Macrina one more time.